you very much. I'm going to request Anjula, Vidya, and Hila to please stay on stage. That's this is Hila ji, haan aap yahan pe aa jaiye, Anjula ji. नहीं नहीं बाएं मत बोलिए, मतलब यहाँ पे हाँ जी सेम टू सेम लग रही है लवली. इला जी, आई वांट टू आस्क यू वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. यू नो एक्चुअली वी बीन गिवन ओनली एन आवर, बट आई थिंक वी कैन गो ऑन फॉर लाइक couple of hours if we have time, because there's so much, right? There's so much to talk about. What a fantastic journey. But sabse pehle, I want to ask you, ki ye naam jo hai, parde ke piche, iske baare mein mujhe bataiye.
Aisa hai ki ek maine gana gaya, to us gaane ke baad mera signature tune ho gaya Choli Ke Peeche. Koi ye bhi janna chahta tha ki Ila Room kya hai, parde ke piche kya. Maine zindagi, aap jante hain, zyada स्टेज पे करी है, फिर स्मॉल स्क्रीन, फिर आपका बड़ा पर्दा. पर्दे के पीछे के लोग कैसे हैं, पर्दे के पीछे की इला कैसी है. मैंने सोचा कि इसका नाम ऐसे करें कि पीछे से वो उसको याद कर लो, पर आना उनको पर्दे के पीछे पड़ेगा मुझे जानने के लिए. क्या बात है.
और आज क्या क्या एक्चुअली किताब में क्या क्या पर्दाफाश किया है?
पर्दाफाश तो क्रिटिक करेंगे. मैंने तो एक इमोशनल जो जिंदगी जो है ना, वो हमेशा एक सी नहीं रहती है. तो मुझे अब तक नर्वसनेस नहीं थी, मैं तब लिखती गई अपने हिसाब से. अच्छा अच्छा ही हुआ, मेरे साथ कभी बुरा हुआ नहीं. तो वो लिखती गई, पर अब मुझे लगा कि ये गड़बड़ कर दी, क्योंकि मैंने एक फिल्म करी थी घूम के तो नवाज के साथ. उसने बेचारे ने वो सोचता रहता मैं लिखूँ लिखूँ लिखूँ. अल्टीमेटली उसकी स्क्रिप्ट कोई ले जाता है, बाद में भेल पूरी उस पर कोई खा रहे होते हैं. तो आज अगर लोगों ने खरीद भी ली तो फिर ड्राइंग रूम से 15 दिन बाद कहीं और जाएगी, उसके 15 दिन बाद कहीं और जाएगी, फिर कबाड़ी के पास जाएगी, और मैं घर घर का चेहरा बन जाऊँगी. इस बात से मुझे ऐसे दुखी हुई, और उसके बाद ये कि कहीं मुझ पर ना भेल पूरी खा दूँ. सो काइंडली या तो खरीदना मत, या फिर कम से कम मुझे संभाल कर.
Hands up to all those who are going to buy this book after this session. Yeah, look at this, look at this.
But yeah. जी, मैं आपसे एक बात कहना चाहती हूँ. मैं 3 दिन से ये किताब पढ़ रही हूँ. जितना मैं I've been very busy with the promotions of my film, पर जब जब वक्त मिला मैंने कुछ चैप्टर्स पढ़े, और मुझे लग रहा है कि ये एक ऐसी किताब है जो आप कभी भी उठा सकते हैं, किसी भी पन्ने से आप शुरुआत कर सकते हैं. इतना मज़ा आया, और मैं तो आपको जानती हूँ कितने सालों से, पर फिर भी लगा कि आपके ऐसे ऐसे पहलू हैं जिससे मैं वाकिफ नहीं हूँ, जो और बहुत एक्साइटिंग. पर वो जो आपका माय फेवरेट थिंग अबाउट इला जी इज हर यू नो चाइल्ड लाइक क्वालिटी, द एक्साइटमेंट, द एंथुजियाज्म फॉर एवरीथिंग शी डज. और मुझे हर पन्ने में वो मिला. तो आई एम एक्चुअली आई डोंट थिंक एनीवन्स इट्स गोइंग टू बिकम भेलपुरी. it's going to be used for that ever. But congratulations, Ila ji. Sorry, Gaurav, I couldn't resist, but come in there.
And also, a big round of applause to Vidya. I mean, she had disappeared, and we haven't seen her after the success of Bhool Bhulaiya 3. But here she is amongst us. What do we got for us? Now, Vidya, since we have, you know, this talked about the success of Bhool Bhulaiya 3 also, can you just tell everyone in the voice of Monjulika? Do we want that?
When there's Ila Arun on stage, no one wants to hear my voice. Just me on that. Really? Ila ji, aap bhi hasa rahi hai. What do I say?
Your name.
Ami Monjulika.
You know, there was a recent survey and a research that happened that people have stopped calling their daughters Monjulika after the film. ये बहुत पहले हुआ था जब प्राण साहब के साथ, I think everyone remembers, all those who are above the age of 75. But yeah, okay. So now एक और चीज़ मुझे, इला जी, क्योंकि मुझे किताब अभी भी नहीं आधे घंटे पहले, ये
She's always been the youngest person
in the room, and I don't mean this in any sort of ageist way, but she's so much fun. You all know that, right? I'd of course seen her on screen, I loved her songs. But when we worked together on three films, Shaadi Ke Side Effects, Begum Jaan and on Sherni, it was just, we would be yapping away in between takes. And yet when the camera came on, she was, you know, she just transformed. And then I also had, you know, the opportunity to watch her on stage, and she's magic. But you know what I love? I said this a little while ago. She's such a child. And I've known Ishita. I think Ishita is great fun, but I think she's actually the child between the two of them. Ishita was my junior in college. And it's just been, I don't know, it's always, it's very easy to talk to her about anything. And because she levels with you, you don't realize how knowledgeable and well-read and what a treasure trove of varied experiences she is. And I think I was always, we formed a sort of a personal relationship, and I was thrilled when she asked me to do this. I was like, really?
She didn't even take a second. She said, I am there.
Yeah, there's no question. I love her. I genuinely, she's one of my most favorite people. She's one of the most favorite people I've come across here. And I have to say that, you know, I have lots of questions going through my mind. Before I delve into any of the personal, you know, memories or anecdotes, I want to say there are questions I want to ask her about the book, because Anjana ji referred to idioms twice in what she said. And one of the first things that I read in the book was the fact that you refer to your mother as the first director of your life. And therefore, to what she taught you as the clapperboard that has kept you on the right path. Avesh ne vivek mat khona. I think, you know, I want to know, of course, I've read the chapter and they will all read it. And that makes its appearance at various points in the book. But it's so beautiful, because aapne actually, you've broken barriers, you've broken the glass ceiling in so many ways at various points, but phir bhi, aapne apna wo vivek kabhi nahi khoya. Having known you personally, I know how there is a certain professional dignity, there is commitment, there is honesty and passion to everything that you do, that you bring to everything that you do. I also love that she gets emotional all the time. Can we get some water, please? So I just want to know, ki.
Anything that anyone says to her, first thing is tears. She brings tears to my eyes also, unfortunately.
Oh, my family ka hai.
You know that Avesh ne vivek mat khona, have you passed that down to Ishita also? And what, and to your grandkids?
Grandkids? But Ishita ke paas to Avesh hai, vivek hai.
But you know, Vidya, I mean, absolutely, I think what you've said, everyone who knows Hila ji, I think feels the same. It's the warmth. We're all here because of Hila ji. Come on, a big round of applause for Hila ji. We love you so much. But I want to tell you, Vidya, that, I mean, I know you know it, but she loves you immensely, that she's dedicated an entire section to you, and I'd like to read that. If it's okay, can I read a bit? मैंने सिर्फ दो chapters पढ़े हैं तो एक तो मैं दोनों पढ़ूँगा. तो one is about Vidya Balan and Farhan Akhtar. Vidya came to the industry through ads, some with my brothers Piyush and Prasoon, and perhaps some television work. she started her work, it was the role in Parinitha that first brought her into the limelight as an actress. I cannot forget how impressed I was when I saw Vidya in Parinitha. She was different from the other actresses who looked like models. She was a mature woman, having the beauty and elegance of the actresses of old times. She brought back the dignity of the original Parinitha, the beautiful Meena Kumari in the 1953 film. In fact, I got to know her well, and on the sets, I got to see how talented she is and how she transforms herself the moment the camera is on her. In Begum Jaan, she was too young to be the madam of a kota. Shabana had done a similar role in Mandi and she looked the part because she was a seasoned actress. She had even put on weight for the role, but for Vidya, it was a great responsibility to take on a role like this at such a young age. I told her that I saw Meena Kumari in her and that she should do Saheb Bibi or Ghulam 1962, which was released originally. She would be perfect for the role. She has the emotional strength to express her pain and her desire, the loneliness of a dejected woman. I also told her that she was the right actress to do a biopic of Meena Kumari. Amongst all the other biopics everyone wants you to do. Her choice of films has been amazing. To take on the role of Dirty Picture after Parinitha was a bold step. The portrayal of Silk Smita was played so convincingly by Vidya that the audience identified her with it. Her role in Kahani as a spy who pretends to be a pregnant woman was also an unusual role for a newcomer. She was fantastic in Sherni too. She's a natural actress and so was able to take on such a vast range of roles and did not hesitate to accept roles that other actresses would shun. She has done some period films and really surprised me in Shakuntala Devi with her rendition of the title role. Another one. Now, Vidya has a childlike quality that endears her to her co-actors. She also loves to play pranks on the set, I want to know about that, which sometimes disturb the shot. On the sets of Begum Jaan, she would play pranks on me too. It was hot in Shantiniketan and the scenes were long. Most of the shots required at least 10 people. Scenes like these were difficult to organize and I would get tired because I would be standing for a long time. She was concerned. She would always look after me. Wow. But when I had scenes with her, she would crack a joke and make others laugh while she kept a straight face. Once while I was preparing for a serious scene, she asked someone to play the song DJ Wale Babu by Badshah. I'd really love to see Vidya and Neeraji dance on DJ Wale Babu. We'll probably do that later if we have the time. She knew that if I hear a tune like that, my feet would naturally tap to the music. The shot was ready and she visited at Shantiniketan. We enjoyed the shop selling trinkets, saris, handloom material. Saris would be less than half the price of what you get in big cities. We loved to listen to the Baul singers who frequented the melas to entertain the villagers. She was always giving me presents. During the shooting of Sherni, she presented me with a heavy silver necklace. It was embellished with bells and when the bells rang as I walked, I was reminded of the cows returning.
Actually, I wanted to wear it and I thought the sound people will not allow.
Ilaji, the point is, main bhi nahi pad pa raha. I'm just cracking up. Okay, where was I? When her husband Siddharth Roy Kapoor came to visit her on location, she took us all out for dinner to a beautiful ethnic place serving delicious Bengali food. Obviously, Siddharth is a very caring husband and they have a very good rapport in our partnership. She saw my energy on location and found, okay, now this is interesting, in fact, I'd rather you say it, but I'll start. She saw my energy on location and found on Wikipedia that my age had been given as 85.
Yeah.
I'm going to stop right here and I'm going to...
How long?
Okay, I'll tell you that, firstly, I'm very flattered that you have a section on me. I don't know how, I guess I haven't gotten there yet. But thank you, Hiraji, that's so sweet. I have to say that, you know, this is not exactly how it plays out in my mind every time I think of the moment. Ilaji was in a white sari. We were doing a holy sequence. And she kept telling the director, many holi khel rahi. Achha, main nahi, rang kuch bhi nahi rahi. So he said, nahi, us waqt to vidwa pe कोई रंग नहीं चल रहा था ना, मतलब कोई रंग नहीं रहा था. तो शी सर अच्छा, देन द डायरेक्टर थॉट ही थॉट अच्छा मैं थोड़ी देर में आपको बताता हूँ. शी वेटेड ऑल डे एंड शी वॉज रियली लाइक अ चाइल्ड. शी वॉज हार्ट ब्रोकन दैट शी वॉज नॉट अलाउड टू प्ले होली. शी वॉज इन अ वाइट साड़ी स्टैंडिंग इन द कॉर्नर एंड सल्किंग. सो दैट्स व्हेन आई सेड ओके डीजे वाले बाबू से गाना चला एंड यू हैव टू सी यू नो. देन आई स्टार्टेड यूजिंग दिस बिफोर एवरी टेक. आई वुड से डीजे वाले बाबू एंड शी वुड स्टार्ट मूविंग. इट वाज इट्स जस्ट हर स्पिरिट इज सो अमेजिंग. एंड देन so I just casually asked her, I checked her out on her. You know, I was like, wow, what energy, and God bless you, she still has that. So I was like, I said, 85 years? I went back to her and I said, really, are you, you know, if you don't mind me asking, how old are you? She said, kyun? I said, Wikipedia pe they're saying you're 85 years old. She said, no, not at all. So then I was really incensed because, you know, anyway, Wikipedia gives out a lot of rubbish information. So I said, we have to correct this. So I got all the girls,
prostitutes and all the actresses.
On the film, we got all of us got together and wrote to Wikipedia saying, please make this correction. But it's quite amazing. We kept making the correction and it would still keep going back to 85 years. So after a while, we gave up when we realized that doesn't matter, you know.
Well, let me tell you something. The age, in any case, for Ila is a big problem because she's got a whole chapter on her birth date.
Oh, lady.
Which her, according to her, her mother never remembered her birthday. So she's lucky. She doesn't know how old she is. So there's this chapter, chapter 2, birthday, blue diary, carried on till the end of her life. And now I have the blue diary in my hand and a date crossed out. The world knows my birthday as March 15th. But my mother would often say, Ila, I can say with certainty that March 15th is not your birthday. I would retort, then do you mean to say that I've made up this date? This was always followed by the same explanation that when my school admissions were taking place, my father was out of town and had deputed his friend Mishri Lal Jain to get us admitted into school. She would say, so he must have entered that date in the form. Horrified. I would say, are you saying that my father does not know when I was born either? This argument between us carried on all her life. For years I quarreled with my mother about my date of birth. But she would often just pass it off as a joke. Sometimes she would say, remember, you're my sixth offspring. And a girl at that. There had already been five girls born before you and two after. I would say, so why did you give birth to girls only? You needn't have. Eight daughters? Either Krishna's mother Devaki had them or my mother. This would embarrass her. Have some shame, she would say. But how do you remember the birth dates of the other sisters? There seems to be no problem with your remembering the dates of the sisters older than I am. And you know the birth dates of those after me. So what happened to your senses in my case? Mat kyun mari gayi thi aapki? Did I not have importance in your life? My entire being, my life, is connected to the date that I was born on. If my date of birth is wrong, then my whole existence is wrong, a lie. I would not let her get the better of me in this feeling. Mother, it is March now. Now do you remember when I was born? Go on. I will never tell you. On her passing away, among her papers, we found this blue diary in which she would record a lot of things. Surprisingly, the diary contained the birth of dates of several people. This time, in front of my name, March 15th had been crossed out. And there was a new entry, 18th February. Finally, she had arrived at that date. During her illness, before she admitted to the hospital, she must have consulted the Hindu calendar, calculated the tithi and the date, trying to jog her memory, and sealed it at February the 18th. Ila Arun, born February 18th. It may be March 5th on my passport, March 15th for my friends, but for me now, it'll always be February the 18th. favorite chapter. We had great fun with this chapter. We read a little bit of it because I think I would also probably, shed tears. You know, you still have dry eyes, I'm surprised. But this was how, she doesn't know her date of birth, so she's quite lucky in that.
But Ila ji, kya hai confusion? Matlab, no, ask Ila ji, you know, it's talking about, look at the multifaceted personality that she is. She's a singer, she's an actor, she's a, hang on a minute. Ila ji, ek request hai. Aapka ek ad aaya tha recently, jisme har dialogue ke baad aapko ek apna Ila-ism karna tha. Oh, chori. So every time I see one aspect of you, you have to respond. Get your cameras on. This is awesome. So, Ila ji, the actor. The writer. The mother.
Oh, chori.
The theater actor, folk singer. You know, I mean, really, there and there's nothing that she hasn't done, including, a composer. She's written most of the plays that she does. She's written them herself. So really, if there is one person who can wear multiple hats and be very good at it, it's Ila Roy.
Sorry, I was going to interrupt you there, since you got the book at the last minute and you haven't been able to go through it that much. The book starts, the chapter Curtain Raiser starts with what Ritwik Ghatak said to you.
Yeah.
It's so beautiful because I think he saw you before you knew where you were headed, before you began to see yourself.
I was in anesthesia.
Yeah, and he said, in Bengali, he said, you will die on stage.
And I died that time.
Yeah, when you were so young. You know, but he could obviously foresee what you yourself could not. I think it's so amazing because you've been on the stage in various avatars, on various stages, in the various stages of your life. And I think it's so beautiful, it's so inspiring. When I read that, I was very moved. And now?
But that's what I really want me to happen. पर कुणाल में तरस आता है बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट टू डाई लास्ट ब्रेथ पृथ्वी पे आगे मिनट अरेंजमेंट कैसे करेंगे तो मेरी इच्छा है मैं लोकेशन ढूंढ रही हूँ यहाँ पे कि वहाँ बट ही डजंट कि मैं देख आई वुड लाइक टू डाई देयर
अब तो उसके लिए बहुत टाइम है इला जी ऑल्सो सॉरी आई हैव लॉस्ट ट्रैक ऑफ व्हाट आई वाज अबाउट टू से
Origin.
Sorry, I thought the origin of my thoughts, so I was going back. In the chapter called Origin, I was asking you backstage if you speak about Kannauj and you speak about Jodhpur.
Yeah.
Yeah? And how Kannauj became the capital of perfumes in India, right? Perfume capital of India.
She's great, amazing, huh? Teen din mein itna itna detail mein padha hai jo hame bhi nahi hai. But this is the perfume I want to give you. You see, I was shooting for Thugs of Hindustan.
हाँ.
और छोटे रोल का तो यही फायदा है कि जहाँ पे भी आप एक बार रोल का आ रहा है तो कार मिल जाती थी वी यूज्ड टू गो एंड ऐसे ही ठग्स ऑफ हिंदुस्तान में फोकस अमिताभ बच्चन पे था तो मुझे नहीं मिल रहा था मैं पूरे वहाँ ऊपर चली गई इनका जो इन्होंने बना रखा गाइडेड टूर वहाँ उसमें मुझे इसने ये पकड़ा है विच आई वॉन्ट टू गिव यू सिंस यू रेड इट इस खुशबू ने मुझे मोटिवेट किया कि मैं अपने रूट्स को पहचान
मॉनसून
कन्नौज की और खुशबू मुझे थी फिर मैंने देखा कि बाप दादे कहाँ से आए थे और मैंने इजीली अपने को रॉयल्टी से जोड़ तो लिया पर थे वो डाकिए हिस्ट्री मुझे तो कुछ खास थे नहीं कोई मास्टर कोई डाकिया नहीं है बस रॉयल्टी से जुड़े गए थे सो दिस इज ऑल योर
बट दिस backstage I was asking Ila ji and she said हाँ मैं तुम्हें भेज दूँगी तुम्हारे लिए भेज दूँगी मुझे लगा कि मेरे घर पर कभी आ जाएगा मुझे पता नहीं था कि you were carrying this for me thank
yes.
you sorry Gaurav I have to
oh,
say
she's a magician too yeah
she is
she's a magician too no but tell me a little bit about the pranks that would happen during the shoot
more than the pranks I will tell you that you know we were a bunch of nine women but Ila ji and I were like little school girls just chatting away and I wanted to because like I said she's a treasure trove of knowledge experiences you know just talents so I would keep asking her things and she kept telling me about her how she started her folk music journey her her time in films the various people she's worked with theater of course which she's so passionate about and then we would go off any time we were staying in Shantiniketan though we were shooting in Jharkhand but on a free day in Shantiniketan I remember one of my favorite memories of Ila ji is in Shantiniketan on Saturdays they have the ball mela so bowl singers basically got together and in the they would have a, like a sort of a heart they would sell handicrafts and things like that and there was so they would be performing and imagine to have Ila Arun perform along with them live for you you know how does it get any better than that and I remember I had a video of it while changing phones I think I misplaced it but I've been trying to look for it actually I was trying to look for it for today but didn't find it it was so amazing and we would go shopping we would go eat something we would just be chatting away So I think pranks. I only remember my director running to us with a bottle which had two baby snakes. You remember that? It was I'm petrified of snakes, and he was running behind us. And I remember there were snakes and scorpions on that set because we were shooting in the wild, you know. So it was quite crazy, but I remember just pulling Ila ji like that when the director walked towards me. It was just like. Hiding behind her because I was so scared, but she's always a sport. She's a sport. She's up to. She'll play along always. That is, it's so amazing, you know.
And you know, just mentioned about how Ila ji performed at the Bowl Fest for everyone. हाँ तो चलिए तो तालियां
ऐसे कैसे
नहीं मैं आपसे प्रॉपर गाना भी गवाऊंगा और दो लाइन भी गवाऊंगा
इसमें कैसे डांस हो सकता है दूसरे में नहीं भाई हमारे में सब नहीं मत करिए
ओके कम ऑन ओके यू सिंग एंड यू नॉट इवन सिंग एंड विल देयर हाँ
मैं तो लाज के मारे हो गए पानी पानी सब लोग गाने
के बाद दे सेड एज सन बाय इला अरुण उनको भी नहीं पता तो ये आप प्लीज हमें बता दीजिए कि कहां क्या था
मैंने जिंदगी में जो कमाई की ना उसमें आधा तो मुझे आज उज हाय लिखा जब मुझे कहते थे अब राजस्थान में कुछ ठेठ ला और लिखने वाला तो उनको इतना पता मैंने अपने आप ही इम्प्रोवाइज किया मुझे ओ रे ढोला हमारी छाती टूटे हमारा डिब्बा चुड़ला टूटे ये टूटे वो टूटे और बहुत अच्छा लगा क्योंकि मैं उसी समय लिखा था एंड दिस इज वन थिंग लाइफ में ऐसा गोल्डन लम्हा बहुत कम लोगों के पास आता है जो मेरे पास आ गया कि मुझे लता जी के साथ गाने का मौका मिला एंड शी से आखिरी में तुमने कसम कर रहा है
Thank you.
Thank you. विद्यामैन तो अब दुनिया जानती है कि मतलब उनसे ज़्यादा कोई जीवंत हो नहीं सकता है। मैंने तीन फिल्मों में इनके साथ काम किया, पर इनकी जैसी मैच्योर्ड, इनकी जैसी बबली, इनकी जैसी सेंसिटिव लड़की मैंने आज तक नहीं देखी। और जो मतलब अदब कायदों के साथ भी खुली हुई बंजारन है, तो मुझे मैं उन्हें बहुत पसंद करती हूँ। और मैं यही कहूँगी कि दिस इज़ बीन वेरी काइंड ऑफ हर। अगर आप उम्र में देखें तो मुझसे छोटी हैं, पर अगर आप एक्सपीरियंस और ओहदे में देखें तो मुझसे बहुत बड़ी है।
नो चांस,
सीरियसली,
दैट्स हाउ ह्यूमिलिटी।
एंड शी सेड यस, एक मिनट में इन्होंने यस कहा, वो बात मैं ज़िंदगी भर याद रखूँगी। और आज जो इन्होंने मेरे साथ किया है ना, उसको मैं किसी भी भूल भुलैया में नहीं भूलूँगी।
या आई वाज सरप्राइज्ड बिकॉज़ आई वाजंट अवेयर ऑफ इट। आई वाज सो टच्ड। Ira ji asked me to launch her book and I was very touched by that itself because I absolutely love her. She's one of my most favorite people. I feel she's a complete entertainer, you know. And look at it. Look at the show she put up today. You know, she performed a monologue from her play and she sang and she danced and she spoke so beautifully like only she can. So I was very touched and
so Vidya, I have to justify my book. Book is all about this. Maine zindagi bhar na chahiye aur zindagi bhar gaya hai.
Nahi, but it's the most honest and fun read. You know, I couldn't put it down. I've hardly been getting any sleep, but once I started reading it, I was like thoda aur padh lu. But I'm going to finish it very soon.
Main ye kehna chahungi Vidya ki तीन दिन में, एक तरफ तो आपने इनको भूल भुलैया में देखा और सारी फिल्मों में आप खुद सब लोग जानते हैं, शकुंतला में मैं इनकी फ़ैन हो गई, पर तीन दिन में इतनी बारीकी के साथ पढ़ना बड़ा मुश्किल है। और एक एक चीज़ इनको याद थी और एक एक चीज़ पे इन्होंने कमेंट किया, इट टॉक्स वॉल्यूम्स अबाउट हर।
पर मेरे बहुत सारे सवाल थे बिकॉज वी वर डूइंग सो मच मस्ती ऑन स्टेज एंड इला जी फॉर मी equals musti. But I have to say, I don't think Kwasar have to ask you whether there's been another session like this at any lit fest ever. That's Ila ji for you. But I'm so
but
thrilled to have been part of it.
Don't you think we should thank Kwasar for this? Either. क्योंकि देखिए ये भी उम्र में बहुत छोटा है और इतना बड़ा लिटरेचर फेस्टिवल इन्होंने किया और उसको इतने शांत बहुत
हिंदी में बोलो
because he told me कि तुम मेरी खिंचाई कर सकती हो क्योंकि मुझे कुछ समझ में नहीं आ रहा।
मैंने इला जी को ये भी कहा था कि उन्होंने अंग्रेजी में लिखा है ताकि मैं पढूं।
हाँ, करेक्ट
करेक्ट। आजकल की जनरेशन कुछ वैसे तो पढ़ती नहीं है, तो मैं अपनी लड़की को भी चाहती थी वो मुझे जान ले मैं मरूं इससे पहले और ये लोग भी जान ले। कम आज कोई बात नहीं, ठीक है। सो दिस इज इशिता एंड विद्या और ये औजार, ये सब सेंट जेवियर्स के, यानी अंग्रेजी दा। सो थैंक यू सो मच, थैंक यू,
थैंक यू। थैंक यू।
आप इस बुक में आए, उसमें एक चैप्टर आपके ऊपर भी है, तो आपने देखा उसको कैसा लगा?
नहीं, मैंने तो उनकी किताब पढ़नी शुरू की कल एक्चुअली, और जब जब टाइम मिला मैं थोड़ा सा पढ़ रही थी, तो वहाँ तक नहीं पहुँची थी तो मुझे पता नहीं था। सो इट वॉज़ अ लवली सरप्राइज फॉर मी। पर ये तो इला जी का बड़प्पन है, मैं और क्या कहूँ। आई एम जस्ट वेरी हम्बल्ड, आई एम वेरी टच्ड एंड आई कांट वेट टू रीड द रेस्ट ऑफ द बुक। इट्स ग्रेट फन एंड शी इज सो ऑनेस्ट लाइक शी इज, विच इज़ वाई यू नो शी स्टेड यंग। शी इज़ ऑलवेज द यंगेस्ट पर्सन इन द रूम, आई ऑलवेज से दिस। एंड शी इज़ अ क्वीन ऑफ एंटरटेनमेंट। गॉड ब्लेस हर एंड मोर पावर टू हर। Oh, I think it's fantastic, especially because we're losing touch with reading. And I love the idea of a physical book still. But thank you to Kwasar and the Live Lit Fest. Literature Live Lit Fest. Kwasar and I go back a long way. We were together in college. So it's fantastic to see him. Of course, he's ruling the stage.
in Mumbai and in the rest of the country, but also I think it's so amazing that he's done this. He's been doing this for a few years now. And more power to you too, Kwasar.
I'm like, ma'am also said that, bhul nahi hai, teri har jagah bhul nahi hai, dekh rahe. So it is a huge success. How are you feeling about that success?
क्या कहूँ बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है या बस मी जे तुम्हार थैंक यू.